It's hard work being a career woman when you're surrounded by rather peculiar employees.
What of?
This can't be me. It's a man's bottle.
I was arrested for drink driving last night.
Welcome to the human race.
Is it legal? Friday at 8:30. Down at the office now, Robert Lindsay is losing control.
She's in early.
Who?
The new boss.
Oh.
I've got a meeting with her this morning.
Oh, yeah, well, watch yourself. Bit of a serious man-eater is what I hear.
Don't be ridiculous.
OK, here's one. If you had to sleep with your boss in order to further your career, would you do it?
Good God, of course not.
Oh, I would.
You'd sleep with her if she just fired you.
True. But I wouldn't spend the night.
Morning, Jim.
Please consider none of the above as administratively active until the interdepartmental consensus has been established. Once ratified, these new objectives must be seen as subaltering current sub-objectives 1 to 4 as outlined in all previous documentation.
Read that back to me, will you?
Read what back to you, Pumpkin?
The letter.
Oh, I thought we were chatting.
How in the name of God, even as a temp, have you managed to hold down secretarial employment?
Well, everyone thinks I'm nice and cheery, don't they? I just sort of jolly everyone along. And if that doesn't work, I sleep with them.
Am I the only person left with any standards? Am I the only one in this entire office who wouldn't sleep with someone just to keep their job?
You want to watch it, you do. What I hear about your new boss.
What do you hear?
Oh, just something the girls were saying this morning.
What?
Nothing.
Now, you've remembered, I'm giving my talk today to all the divisional managers.
Conference hall, 10 o'clock.
This sink is still blocked. Prue, didn't you manage to get hold of maintenance?
Their phone isn't working.
Oh, is it? Marvellous. Absolutely perfect.
Do you want me to have a look at it? I'm ever so good with plumbing.
Just get maintenance, Prue.
No, really, I've got such an affinity with toilets.
Maintenance.
Do you want me to get that?
That would be very nice.
Hello, Mr. Platt's office.
Oh, sorry to interrupt, Mr. Platt. Your suit and shirt.
What?
Your wife, your phone. Said she changed her mind about the suit you should wear for the talk.
Mr. Platt.
She uses one of our bikes so she can just...
Mr. Platt.
Listen, quiet. Listen, dump it over there. And listen, Nigel, if she phones again, tell her she's a deranged old sow and Transatlas dispatch riders are not her personal property.
You're a deranged old sow and Transatlas dispatch riders are not your personal property.
Yeah, right. You better be going.
It's your wife, Mr. Platt.
Sorry about that, darling. Little misunderstanding.
Who was that?
Oh, it's some stupid temp they've given me. Angela's still not back. We were talking about this other sow, and she really is terrible.
I was only going to say your motorbike man took the wrong suit.
Darling, we were 3 hours choosing the suit I've got on. All right? And I've only got to talk to the divisional managers.
Mr. Platt, I'm running ahead. I'll do you now.
Norman, are you there?
Darling, I must go.
But your suit!
Come in, come in.
Right. Sorry.
You're giving a talk to the divisional managers, aren't you?
Shortly, yes.
I'll be there.
Good.
In the meantime, I've been reviewing your work for the company.
Ah, right.
I like what I see.
Oh, well, good.
I think I can do things with you.
Well, that's good, isn't it? That's great.
We can definitely do things.
Yeah, I'm sure we can.
Jason, hold all my calls. I don't want to be interrupted for any reason, clear?
Yes, Miss Drummond.
Confidentially, very confidentially. There's a new senior executive position opening up.
Really? Well, I didn't know.
Some people might think you were ideal. I might too. I very well might.
My God.
You're surprised.
Well, it wasn't what I was expecting.
Not what people told you about me?
No.
There's a catch to this new appointment, Norman.
Ah, right, yes. Well, there's always a catch, isn't there?
Sex.
Pardon?
Sex, Norman. I can call you Norman, can't I?
Yes.
Sex is the catch, Norman. Okay, down to business. I've only got 10 minutes before my meeting with the CEO. On the desk. I'll be back in a moment.
Now?
Oh, now's good for me, Norman. Is it good for you? It's a new world, Norman, with new rules. But I guess you're starting to realize that.
What?
On the desk. As I say, catches, they want to appoint a woman to this new post. Strictly between you and me, I think you're the right person for the job. Trouble is, it's fairly noticeable that you're a man. So how does it feel to be on the receiving end of sex discrimination?
I'm just looking for a report. They did the last place I worked.
Gender stereotyping in the workplace. I think it would impress the CEO if you worked some of it into your speech today. Norman? Norman? Mr. Blair?
To his office?
I'll check.
Hello?
Joan, hi, it's Norman here. I see you've got Hillary with you. Put her on, will you?
Miss Drummond, there's a call for you. I'm transferring it.
Hello, Hillary Drummond.
Hello, Hillary, it's Norman here.
Where the hell are you?
I'm sorry about that. Just had to dash off. I'm back in my office.
Had some emergency work I had to get on with, and I tell you what, why don't you carry on with your chat with the CEO, and maybe we can meet up after lunch.
Norman, I'm in your office.
I'm in the toilet.
I just popped into the bathroom. I didn't realise you were out there.
You've got a phone in your bathroom?
Yes. Yes. Because of my bowel problem.
Oh. That's why I had to go dashing off like that. A bit embarrassing, really. Couldn't really mention it, of course.
So sorry, I didn't realise you were ill.
Oh, it's all right. It's just a world-class attack of the runs, that's all.
Hello. Just helping out with Mr. Platt's plumbing. Couldn't get maintenance to touch it. I mean, can you believe those people?
So, what do you think?
After lunch?
Lunch?
Yeah.
Yeah, after lunch would be best, I think.
Is there anything I could get you?
It's all right. I've sent my secretary out for something.
Honestly, the things we do for our men.
Yes. Okay. Well, I'll leave you to it then, Norman.
I'll leave you the report. Remember, gender stereotyping in the workplace. Get it into your speech.
Fine. Absolutely.
I'd better get back to my office.
Yes.
Sarah, I don't quite know how to say this, but I've been seeing someone else.
Creamy smooth Hellman's mayonnaise in a conveniently squeezable pack.
Whatever's going on outside, you'll always feel really good inside.
I think it's all over. It is now.
The new Rover 200.
Hello, Mr. Platt's office.
This is Mrs. Platt.
Oh, hello.
It's about my husband's suit. He's got quite the wrong one.
Excuse me.
Hillary.
I mean, good eye, Miss Drummond. I didn't expect to see you here.
I work here.
I know that. I thought you were seeing the CEO.
He cancelled. How did you know that?
I didn't. I didn't know. When I said seeing, I meant dating.
You thought I was dating the CEO?
Well, obviously I'm wrong. I just assumed you were dating because you got the job. Not that he gave you the job because you had sex or anything. I'm not saying that. I mean, that would be really silly. I mean, not that you're bad at sex or anything. I mean, I'm sure you're really, really good at it. You know, everyone says so. Not that everyone knows, of course. It's just so obvious that you have sex a lot. Well, not a lot as such, but that you do it really, really well. I mean, I'll bet you could do it professionally.
And you are?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No, my voice is shut.
You find your behaviour distinctly odd.
Yeah, oh, no. Really sorry.
Sorry. Where were we?
Hello, Mr. Platt's office.
Prue! It's Mr. Platt. Listen.
Oh, Mr. Platt, where are you? Your wife was looking for you.
Actually, I'm right, Nick. What does she want?
Your suit. You've got the wrong one.
She's taken the suit.
Well, she's arranged for it to be collected. I've got it in my office.
No one's to touch it. No one's to touch it. Do you understand me?
Well, your wife was very insistent. I really think I ought to...
An order! Do you understand me? The suit mustn't leave the building.
But what if she phones again? She gets ever so cross.
Prue, listen. It's a plot.
It is an evil plot to steal my suit. Like in the films. Do you understand me?
A plot?
Yes. And together, we have to foil it. You with me?
Do you know, there was a suspicious character hanging about. Hang on a moment.
Prue, wait!
Mr. Platt, there's definitely a suspicious character hanging about in the vicinity.
That may well be. The man who's going to steal my suit will not be a suspicious character. He may well be disguised as a dispatch rider. But on no account, under no circumstances, must he get hold of that suit. Stop him at all costs, got me?
Could you just give me one moment?
Prove.
What the hell is going on?
Oh, good day again, Miss Drummond. I expect you're wondering why I'm lying here on the floor. The thing is, I'm just giving Prue here a lesson in the old self-defense. The trouble with you English Sheilas, you don't know how to handle an angry Bruce when you see one.
Mr. Platt popped out, by the way. He's just popped down in the old conference hall. Have a little word with those divisional managers. But that's the thing about old Norman, isn't it? Hey! Work. I don't know. The thing I will say about old Norman, and he's always been...
a wonderful brother to me.
Brother?
We're twins. Twin brothers. Though, obviously, I was born in Australia. And so was he. Because we're twins. Of course, a bit embarrassing for him, me being a rider here, so I usually keep my helmet on.
Mr. Platt.
No! I'm not Mr. Platt. I'm... Mr. Platt.
Oh, dear. Mr. Platt.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. God.
What's wrong with you, then?
She doesn't believe me. She didn't believe a word.
Well, even I didn't believe you, sweet pea. Oh. I mean, twins.
Oh, you're nothing like him.
I am Gabriel Bosk! I'm Mr. Platt! I'm Norman Platt, for Christ's sake!
Oh!
Oh, God. I don't believe it. I'm finished.
Oh, I see. I get it now.
I've ruined my career in one morning.
Have you, honey? Why?
I've just convinced my new boss that I think I'm my own imaginary biker twin. That's the kind of thing that gets mentioned in your annual performance evaluation. Oh, God.
Go away. Go on. Go away.
I need to die now.
I've got an idea, honey. I've got a little plan.
Go away.
Just a moment.
Go away and stay away.
Oh. Now. You get into your nice suit, and I'll put on your biker gear and pretend to be your brother. And then Miss Drummond won't think you're mad anymore.
What?
Because you'll have to do the voice like a ventriloquist on the telly. Have you seen them? They're ever so clever.
that's your plan?
It's good, isn't it?
That is without doubt the worst plan in the history of the entire universe.
Well, that's very nice, isn't it?
Norman, isn't it about time you were gone?
I want you to put on this leather gear, put on an Australian accent, and pretend to be my brother.
No, I mean, I do approve of adventurous sex, but...
Where'd you keep the, biker's gear?
I'll do an Australian accent.
Gordon, I don't care. Just do it. I've got to do my speech right now. Gordon, she's coming back. Just come.
Mr. Platt? Mr. Platt? Mr. Platt?
Would you please come out the bathroom? She's here.
Good day again, Miss Drummond. I'm sorry about the confusion earlier, but everything seems to be back to normal, yeah?
What the hell is this? What's going on?
What? Nothing's going on. I can't see anything going on.
What are you doing?
Well, you see, Mrs. Platt phoned about her husband's suit. Apparently, he's got the wrong one.
And it takes two of you?
No, just me.
Well, g'day all. Mrs. Platt phoned again. Asked me to pick up her husband's suit. Apparently, he's got the wrong one.
It takes three of our dispatch riders to carry one suit. Can anyone explain that to me? Can anyone explain anything that is going on in this damned office? Because I think I need some help here!
Oh, sorry about that, Miss Drummond. Oh, God, I've got to help with that suit.
Okay, Mr. Platt.
What is going on with you guys?
Nigel, please give me this suit.
You give me this one first. Why have you stolen one of our suits?
Nigel, I'm about to give a speech on stage to every divisional manager in the Southeast in front of my new boss. And I'd rather not do it naked. That would be a bad thing.
We've got to move.
Nigel, give me this. Nigel.
Go on, Steve. Hi, everybody. Well, without any more ado, let's get on with it. And let's have a nice, big round of applause for my man and your man, Norman. Platt. He'll be out in a minute.
He's here. Who is the CEO?
Oh, God.
Okay, I can do this. I can turn this around. This is my chance. Now I'll show that bitch something she's never seen before.
Here today to talk about a very important thing. I'm here today to talk about gender stereotyping in the workplace.
find us in the office of a West End talent agency next week. The 10 Percenters, back with a new series and more bookings at 8:30.
On today's All Too Revealing Snap, how Robert Lindsay bears all in the office and fascinating facts about Friends in the chart.
I'm Robert Lindsay.
I'm Isla Blair.
Stefan Dennis here. And you're watching the hottest TV news on Snap,
Cackle
and Pop.
TV news.
We started the reading and I looked around and everyone was staring at me and I just suddenly stopped the reading and I said, I'm not going to be able to wear these wife fronts, am I? No.
Robert Lindsay holds nothing back in his new ITV comedy, The Office, in which he plays Norman Platt, okay. A company manager who's terrified when his new boss, Isla Blair, makes an indecent proposal.
On the desk. I'll be back in a moment.
Now?
Oh, now's good for me, Norman. Is it good for you?
Disaster strikes when he takes her orders a little too literally.
That was the worst thing, was actually getting the kecks off and running around an office full of women.
And not being able to put them back on again.
I had a real problem looking at Robert. What can I tell you? I was sent out of the studio on one occasion for laughing. Very bad.
Stefan Dennis wasn't too impressed with Robert Lindsay's impersonation of him.
Oh, good day again, Miss Drummond. I expect you're wondering why I'm lying here on the floor.
Dreadful. As an Australian accent. I mean, his impersonation of a biker, fine. His Australian accent, no.
Stefan hopes his cameo role as a bike courier will put neighbours behind him.
I feel I'm finally starting to sort of shake off the hindrance of neighbours and sort of get my foot in the door here.
Robert Lindsay made his name as Wolfie in Citizen Smith 20 years ago. His role in The Office was a whole new experience.
I've stacked a few shelves in the supermarkets, I've cleaned a few windows and I've bussed at Tottenham Court Road tube station, but I've never worked in an office.
And he's never had to bear all quite like this before.
I decided after that I would go to the gym. It's a bit late, really. So I'm in better shape now than I was when I did The Office. The first time I was aware that little bits were dropping, so I did a lot of sucking in.